Formatting your perfect resume. First off, Times New Roman is still the most widely used official font. So use that. And if you use Times New Roman, you should use 11 point. And not 10, not 12. So Times New Roman, 11 point. Page layout, you should have margin 1 inch all around. Now, one of the most important thing in CV or resume is to keep the formatting consistent. To keep the formatting consistent in Word and squeeze more stuff into a Word file, single page, if you are making a resume. If you're a fresh graduate or up to 2-3 years of experience, you should have just one page resume, not more than that. So if you want to do that, you're gonna do two tables. Number one, table number one will contain your contact information and your name. So that is just the table one. And then you're gonna be typing your cell phone number here, and then email address here. I'm gonna have one more. Then cell phone, email, and then your name here. So your name goes here, and your physical address should be here, 120 Drive. And then the city name, and then the state name, basically the two words and the zip code, like that. And then your name, what you're gonna be doing this one is basically merge this cell and make it middle justification and make it a little bit bigger, not just make it maybe 14 or 16, and then make it caps, small caps. So it kind of creates a headings for the next section. So like that. And then once you're done with that, the first thing you're gonna be doing is to change the formatting. So right click on that plus sign, and then go to the table properties and change this. So cell options, and then don't leave any space between borders and the words or letters, and then hit OK. So because we're gonna be deleting this border later on. So after that, you insert the second table for the content. For the content, you need a 2x infinite, 2x20. So the first thing you're gonna put is the core competencies. Core competencies, and also format that using that cap small, so make it something like that. However, left justification, and this right column you'll be leaving for the basically the dates or month and year. You don't have to make this 14, just leave it 11 point like that. So this is basically you're gonna be doing the month and year. When did you have, how long are you comfortable with that core competence? And check the other videos where I talk about what content to put. This one is primarily on the formatting. So you're gonna be creating this table, and then make this one shared this, so to create some kind of heading like that, and then shared this one as well. I think I'll use the other one a little bit. So like that. And then you will put your core competencies here, and then type here. And then once you need more, you may, let's say you are right here, keep tab, it will just produce more of these cells. Now, once you finish writing, your resume will look something like this. So it will look like this. Once you finish typing all your stuff in there, and just do what I did there. And then after that, what you're gonna be doing is right click on that, and then hide the borders. So select the entire table, and then select no borders. That will hide the do no borders. So if you do no border, it will look something like this. Look how nice it is looking. However, you should not send resume in a Word file format. You should always be sending as a PDF. So save as PDF, like that. And then this is what we'll be sending to your potential employer. Look how nice it looks. If you print it, it will look really nice. You can squeeze more stuff in there by using the table, and you can also keep the formatting consistent. So that's it about formatting resume in Word.